وسلم أجمعين. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We seek Allah's forgiveness and have a witness that the Allah promote your worship, said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And have a witness that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seed of the prophets. May peace and blessing be upon him and his companion and those who follow his sunnah until the day of judgment. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, our topic today in this khutbah will be about steadfastness, or being straight to the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or to be a person of conscience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what we call in Arabic al-istiqama, al-istiqama, being straight to the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The importance of al-istiqama can be easily seen in the Quran and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Every day we read Surah Al-Fatiha 17 times, 17 rak'ahs every day, because the prayers al-fard, Salat al-Fard, consists of 17 rak'ahs, starting from Salat al-Fajr up to al-Isha. It consists of 17 rak'ahs. And in each rak'ah, we read or recite Surah Al-Fatiha. And Surah Al-Fatiha, categorically, can be divided into three parts. One part, which is the last part of Surah Al-Fatiha, is where we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-istiqama. And we say, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. Oh Allah, guide us to the right path. Sirat al-Mustaqim, guide us to the right path. And then we describe the kind of path that we are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to. Then we say, Sirat al-Ladina an'amta alayhim, ghayr al-maghdubi alayhim wal ad-dallin, which means this is the characteristics of the path, which says, guide us to the right path, and this path, the sign is, غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. Sirat al-Mustaqim is a path that people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have angry upon them did not follow that path. And the people that went astray from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't go to that path. So in other words, you are saying, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I don't want to follow the path of people who went astray and people who you have anger upon them, which are the Jews and the Christians, as the explanation of the surah is. So al-istiqama is we ask straight path. Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, put me to this straight path. I want to stick to that. I want to maintain that. This is what we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every day, minimum 17 times when we recite Surah Al-Fatiha. Now, this path, our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained to us, he demonstrated this to us in practice. One day, our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam drew a straight line on the ground. Straight. You can picture that in your mind. And on the left side and the right side of this straight path, he had drawn a shorter lines, smaller lines, or what we call feeders, or exodus. And then he said, هذا صراط الله المستقيم. This is the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see this straight path that you see, this one is the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. That nobody can get lost in this. It's broad day highway, broad daylight highway. Okay? And in this smaller exodus of feeders, these are, in every exit, there is a shaitan. Shaitan. Yad'uk, calling you from the path. Okay? This means that shayateen, temptations. A lot of temptations. You know, as you try to stick the path, as you try to be a good Muslim, as you try to avoid things that are haram, as you try to increase your iman, as you try to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all of a sudden things pop up from left and right. Isn't that what happens to every one of us? That's what happens. So these are shayateen who want to call you, who want to deviate you actually from the path, from the right path. Here you will see halal, haram money somewhere there. You see here some kind of a woman there, some kind of, temptations in life. Full of temptations. This life is full of temptations. So then Allah, then he recited this ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ. This is my right path. Follow the path. Stick to that path. وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُ السُّبُلَ. And do not take this path. This is more exits on the left and the right. وَلَا تَتَّبِعُ السُّبُلَ. فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِ. So that you will be deviated from the path. So what we are talking about today is how can we maintain this straightness, steadfastness. This is what we are talking about. Now the importance of this can be also found in the Quran, in so many ayah, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. Those who say Allah is our Lord, ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا, then they stick to that path. تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ, that the angels descend upon them. What are they carrying? What is the message that the angels have brought? Allah تَخَافُ, not to have a fear. وَلَا تَحْزَنُ, not to worry. Not to have a fear, neither to worry. وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ, and they are bringing the glad tidings to go to the Jannah. بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوعَدُونَ. Now in Arabic, the difference between al-khawf wal-huzn. What is the difference between worry and fear? The difference is that when we talk about fear, fear is something that you are about to face. It is something in the future, something that has not happened yet. So you have a fear that this thing will happen. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, after you die, no fear. You should not have any fear because you will go to the Jannah. Worry is something that you have passed, something that's behind you, but you worried about it. What will happen? How is that? What will be? It's something that's passed. So, لا خوف عليهم, no fear, nor they shall worry. وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them the glad tidings to go to the Jannah. In another ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the same ayah, or another ayah, وَأَلَّوْ اسْتَقَامُوا عَلَى الطَّرِيقَ. If mankind would have to stick to the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَأَسْقَيْنَاهُمْ مَاءً غَدَغًا, that we would have give them rain with big drops, which means ni'mah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we would have been on the path, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have given us a lot of ni'mah, a lot of rain. You see people, there are droughts nowadays all over the place because of our disobedience. Now in addition to that, one day a man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he said, Ya Rasulullah, قُلْ لِي فِي الْإِسْلَامِ قَوْلًا قُلْ لِي فِي الْإِسْلَامِ قَوْلًا لا أسأله عنه أحدا بعدك. Tell me something in Islam that I would not ask anybody behind me. Just something that I stick to. He said, قل آمنت بالله ثم استقم. Two words. آمنت بالله, believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ثم استقم, and stick to that. You see, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam words was so deep, so brief but so deep. This is one of the signs of the prophethood of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said in authentic hadith, "Nusirtu bi jawami' al-kalim." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have assisted me with combined words. Okay, where he says a very short word but has a very very deep meaning. Nusirtu bi jawami' al-kalim. He said to this man, "Qul amantu billah thumma istaqim." Say I believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you stick to that. So this is what we are talking about today. The ulama, when they explain this, they said, Al-Imanu Billah is the Quran. Al-Istiqama is the Sunnah. Al-Imanu Billah means what you believe. Al-Quran and Al-Sunnah. They also said that Al-Imanu Billah, Al-Istiqama is Al-Imanu Billah wal-Amal al-Salih. You see, to believe in Allah. So everything starts with believing. Creep.
aqida. What do you believe? So al-imanu billah. And then al-amal salih, good deeds. You see, sometimes you will see people who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yet they don't do the rituals and the deeds that they are expected to do so. So it's not enough to say, I'm a believer, yet you don't do what you're supposed to do. And I wonder when I see people who will say, oh, I believe, I'm a good believer, I'm a good person, yet that person does not perform the prayers. Okay? Or yet that sister may not necessarily wearing the hijab. You see, it's good to have a good heart, or good mind, okay, or good iman, but that should be followed by good deeds, al-amal al-salih. Yes, good belief is required, but you also need to do good deeds. You need to pray 5 times a day, you need to avoid things that are haram, you need to do things that are right, and so on, and obeying the commandments and orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then another hadith that I'd like to mention is that Mu'ad ibn Jabal one time wanted to travel, and he said, O Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, I'm traveling. What would you advise me? He said, U'budullah wa la tushrik bihi shay'a. Worship in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and do not associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the advice that he gave. قال يا رسول الله قال يا رسول الله زدني. He said, give me more, tell me more, increase it for me. He said, إذا أسأت فأحسن. When you make mistake, repent. When you make mistake, go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will make a mistake no matter what. Everybody is subject to commit some kind of a mistake or a sin. This is the nature of mankind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَخُلِقَ الْإِنسَانُ ضَعِيفًا. The difference is that good people repent. Bad people do not repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the difference. It is not who makes mistake or not. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made you weak, so much you can commit sins, different kind of sins. Although the believers will not commit al-kaba'ir. But even if you commit, you have to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kana yastaghfiru rabbah. He used to seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أكثر من 70 مرة وفي رواية 100 مرة, more than 100 times every day. وقد غفر الله ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر. Although Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave all his sins and will not commit any sin, yet he was seeking the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was repenting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 100 times a day. What about us who are making so many mistakes every day? So you're subject to make a mistake, but the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all you need is to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَتْبِعِ السَّيِّئَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ تَمْحُهَا. Follow the mistake that you have done with good deeds, with the repentance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All you have to say sincerely from your heart, oh Allah, forgive. Allahumma ghfirli. Astaghfirullah al-azim. Alladhi la ilaha illa huwa wa huwa al-hayyul qayyum. All you have to do is, oh Allah, forgive me. This is what you need to do. You know, you don't need to go through anybody like other religions. When you are seeking the forgiveness or repentance, when you are seeking the repentance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no need to go through anybody. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees you from his heavens. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. If they ask me about you, oh Muhammad, tell them I'm near to them. قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ. I accept the dua and the supplication of the one that's calling me. So Allah hears you. Allah accepts the dua, your repentance. So repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِذَا أَسَعْتَ فَأَحْسِنُ. When you make mistake, do better, do good. And then he said, زِدْنِي يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. I need more. This is what they were looking. You see, companions of Rasulullah ﷺ, unlike us, they were all asking good things. You will see them asking, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ أَيُّ صَدَقَةِ أَفْضَلْ أَيُّ الْأَعْمَالِ أَفْضَلْ أَيُّ الْجِهَادِ أَفْضَلْ. This is what they were asking all the time. You know, to increase their ibadah, to maximize their ibadah and the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said, استقل ولتحسن خلقك. And then he said, استقل, straight, stick to the path. Try to stick to the path, okay? And this is what you need to strive. والذين جاهدوا فينا لنهدينهم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, those who strive, okay? If you don't strive, if you don't work hard toward your religion, then things will not come just like that. It needs strife. Just as much as we are trying to get the worldly things, we need also to strive our religion. We need to strive to be good people. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will give us the guidance after that. But if you don't come up your side of striving or trying hard, okay, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not give you. At-taghyir, the change comes within ourselves. The change will not come from up. It has to start from you. Inna Allah la yughayyiru ma biqawmin hatta yughayyiru ma bi'anfusihim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not change the status of people until they themselves start changing. The change has to come from you. You have to decide yourself what you want to do. It will not just come like that. And then once you come up with good intention and a decision, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promise you will help you with from there on. From there on. But the change comes within ourselves. لا يغير ما بقوم حتى يغير ما بأنفسهم. Allah will not change our status, our situation, unless we change ourselves. Now, istiqama means to, when we say istiqama means that you are on the path. You're engaged on the right path, okay? In other words, if it's fasting, you are fasting. Death comes to you, and it's Ramadan, you are fasting. Now you are on the path, on the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Death comes to you, and you have already prayed your salah, okay? You are in situation of submission, al-istislam. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu taqullaha haqqa tuqati wa la tamutunna, and do not die without a state of submission. وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. You have to be always in a state of submission. Because you never know when the death will come to you. Imagine if the death comes to you in a situation that you are disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالْخَوَاتِمِ. That the amal, okay, is how you ended, how your life ends. That's your destiny. Sometimes you will see people who are good, doing good deeds, and then at the end, they die in a very bad situation. نَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ. Okay, that's why Rasulullah said, فَوَاللَّهِ الَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ غَيْرُهُ إِنَّ أَحَدَكُمْ لَيَعْمَلُ بِعَمَلِ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ حَتَّى مَا يَكُونُ بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَهَا إِلَّا ذِرَعٌ فَيَسْبِقُ عَلَيْهِ الْكِتَابُ فَيَعْمَلُ بِعَمَلِ أَهْلِ النَّارِ فَيَدْخُلُهَا. He said, by Allah, one of you will show the deeds of good people, the deeds of the believers, as people see. But then the person dies in the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of a sudden. As on the contrary to that, some of you will do the deeds of people of Jahannam. You will see this person engaged to so many evil things. But with the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ending becomes nice. That's with the submission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The person repents all of a sudden, just before the death comes to the person. For وَاللَّهِ الَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ غَيْرُهُ إِنَّ أَحَدَكُمْ لَيَعْمَلُ بِعَمَلِ أَهْلِ النَّارِ حَتَّى مَا يَكُونُ بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَهَا إِلَّا ذِرَاعٌ فيسبق عليه الكتاب فيعمل بعمل أهل الجنة فيدخلها into the Jannah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make our ending that which is right, that which is disobedient, that which is obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وإنما الأعمال بالخواتم. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said, من كان آخر كلامه لا إله إلا الله دخل الجنة. Whomever the last word that you utter is لا إله إلا الله, you enter the Jannah. La ilaha, oh Allah, make la ilaha illallah our last word that we say. Now, if we talk about things that how can we stick to the path now? Some of the issues that I'd like to mention. Now, I talked about the importance of steadfastness. How can we maintain this? Part of it we mentioned, but some few points I'd like to mention, about four important points that will make us stick to the path. One of them, al-ikhlasu lillahi ta'ala, sincerity. When we are doing a deed, when we are doing an amal, we have to be sincere to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our objective should be that of pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to get the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is very important. Al-ikhlas. وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ. Mankind, people are not being commanded nothing but to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely. Sincerity is very important. Very important that whatever you do, while you are praying, when you are giving, when you are teaching, when you are engaged in da'wah, when you are doing something good, when you are providing for us, that you should do this for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to gain the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if you have other agendas, such as to show off, or other agendas to increase your group, or hizb, or movement, or tribe, or so on, then that is not for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah does not need any ibadah that's combined with something else. It has to be purely, solely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-ikhlas. Al-Ikhlas, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ مُخْلِسِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ, that the deeds are subject for the intention. Allah knows our intentions. So when you're doing a deed, when you're doing some kind of a ritual, what is your intention? And Allah knows. مَا فِي الصُّدُورِ, He knows what's in our hearts. Whether you mean this for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or whether you have something behind that, or whether you have an agenda or something hidden there, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ya'lam ma fi sudur. Nothing can be hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So number one article that will keep you to the straight path is al-ikhlasu lillahi tabaraka wa ta'ala. You don't pray because you say people, oh, he does not pray, he does not perform the salat. Because among the community you will be a person that, oh, he's not a good person. Not because you want to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not because you fear for your akhirah. You see, there's a difference. There is a difference. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in hadith, فَرُبَّ سَائِن. There are so many people who are fasting that they're not getting anything except hunger. فَرُبَّ قَائِن. So many people who are standing in prayers that they will not get any ajr because the intention is not right. The intention is not right. So we have to purify our intention. إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks our intention. What do we have in mind? What is our objective? What are we trying to reach? So that is number one. Number two, that will maintain us to the path of steadfast is فِعْلُ الطَّاعَاتِ وَاجْتِنَابِ الْمُحَرَّمَاتِ. فِعْلُ الطَّاعَاتِ means to do good deeds. Whatever you can increase the good deeds, whatever you can do, more prayers, more salah, more sadaqah, more things that you can do for yourself while you are healthy, while you are able to do so, because there will be a time that you will not be able to do so. Maybe you get sick, maybe you will die, maybe this and this will happen. So as you are able, as they say, able body, then you should increase your ta'at. And every time that you do something good, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It adds to your hasanat. It increases your iman. So let's increase our iman. You see, we cannot just do few things, just the basic things. The more you do for yourself, man amila salihan fali nafsi, whatever you do, it is for you, it's your saving, it will add to your saving. Fi'lu ta'at. Okay? So ask yourself, what do I do basically? Other than I pray the 5 times a day, what else do you do for your own good, for your saving? What? This is very important. How much Quran do you recite? How much sadaqah do you give? How much sunnah do you pray? How much do you fast? How much do you teach? How much do you learn? Okay? How much do you help mankind and people? Do you provide for some? This is very important that we increase our deeds while we can. Because Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said there will be a time. اغتنم خمسا قبل خمس. Take advantage of 5 things. 5 good things that we have. Before that, there will be a 5 that will take away from you. There's a 5 good things. So many pleasures, so many ni'mas, bounties and graces that we enjoy. And among them there are 5. And there will be 5 that will take away from this. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, شبابك قبل حرمك. Take care of your youth while you're young and able, and do something before you become very old. And as you get older, ask me, as you get older, you get weaker. You cannot do all the things that you used to do. Because your body becomes weak. It's natural, it's normal. You see, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَن نُعَمِّرْهُ نُنَكِسْهُ فِي الْخَلْقِ. Whomever we give age, we reduce the capacity and the ability to anything. Okay? Shababika qabla haramik. Wasihatika qabla saqamik. Take care of your healthy before you become sick. Because no matter what, you'll get sick. And then you'll reach in a position that you can't do much because you're sick. You have some kind of diseases, different kind of diseases that will come. And as you grow older, diseases pop up here and there, increase. You get this and this and this and this leads to this and this leads to this and this leads to this. And then all of them leads to death at the end. So, sihatika, health, while your health, qabla saqamik. Wa ghinaka qabla faqrik, while you have something to give, take before Allah takes away from you. Don't think that the little bit that you have, that you will be remaining like this. Who knows how many people were rich up here and then all of a sudden, you know, you see them begging. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who gives. So don't think that this will be, it is not permanent. So take care of that. Give what you can give. Put it more. It's for you. You're saving. Okay? Wa ghinaka qabla faqrik. Wa firaqika qabla shughlik. Take advantage of your time before you become busy. Okay? And I wonder when I see people who are wasting their time. Time is very important. We should not be wasting 1 minute. A second counts. And I wonder people who are, you know, watching movies and games and playing cards and sitting in a restaurant for hours and hours and hours talking about politics and this and that, wasting all day long for something that does not have anything, any value. Something that you cannot do anything about it. Take it. The time, they say time is money. I say time is better than money. Yeah, time is better than money. A second that's passed will never come back to you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask you, the day of judgment, every minute, every second of your time, what have you done? You could have done so many things. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا يزال قدم عبد يوم القيامة حتى يسأل عن أربع. That somebody will not move a foot in the day of judgment from the hisab, from the question and answer. You will not move a foot until you respond to four questions. One of them is your time. What have you done with the time? Have you used your time wisely? Have you wasted? Okay, have you used disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Every minute counts. And there's always an advantage that you can take. So, فعل الطاعات. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَمَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَاءِ وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا افْتَرَضْتُهُ عَلَيْهِ. That the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the most, that we come close to Him, is the wajib, the fard. Okay? وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ وَمَا يَزَالُ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلْ حَتَّى أُحِبَّهُ. That whenever you do nawafil, things that are sunnah, that will lead to the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will love you. When you increase your nawafil, things that are good, sunnah, that increases the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So much so that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَإِذَا أَحْبَبْتُ, once Allah loves somebody, كُنْتُ سَمْعُهُ الَّذِي يَسْمَعُ بِهِ, I become his hearing. You know, I'll give him, he will hear good things. وَبَصَرُهُ الَّذِي يَبْصِرُ بِهِ, he can see things well. وَيَدُهُ الَّذِي يَبْطُشُ بِهَا, I will become his hand. His hand is blessed. His hand, whatever he wants to do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give barakah and blessing to it. وَرِجْلُهُ الَّتِي يَمْشِي بِهَا, everything. وَإِنْ سَأَلَنِي, and if he asks me something, لَوْ أُعْطِيَنَّهُ, I will give it to him. وَلَئِنْ اسْتَعَاذَنِي, if he seeks refuge from me, from the shaitan, لَأُعِيدَنَّهُ. It is very important that we do that. Now, I'd like also to mention that always we need to have knowledge. Another point that will increase us to steadfastness is to increase our knowledge. I'm referring to Islamic knowledge here. Okay? Islamic knowledge. The other knowledge is as well important also. You know, we need to have educated people in our Muslim community. Yes, we need that. I am not belittling, however, whatsoever. We need doctors, we need engineers, we need accountants, we need all kind of people. We need managers, we need people of experience. We need, that is very important. But what is more important is our Islamic knowledge. You know, if you have the, you know, the highest knowledge, yet you don't even know how to perform your prayers, it's sad. So we need to increase our knowledge. And nowadays, alhamdulillah, knowledge is being simplified. It is available everywhere at your own time. Long time ago, at the time of the companions, one person would have walked from, in fact, this is authentic, a companion of Rasulullah ﷺ walked from Medina, the city of Medina, now in Saudi Arabia, to Egypt, Al-Qahira, to Cairo, for one hadith. Imagine how many kilometers. There's no, at the time there was no airplane or train or cars or anything. He was either on foot or on a horse cart, or you know, on horseback, whatever, to hear one hadith. And with the grace and the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in one setting of khutbah or a lecture, you may hear so many hadith or so many ayahs, yet we are not taking advantage of it. We're not benefiting. So knowledge is available at your fingertips with the technology. Knowledge is available. Even if you're busy, if you're very busy at your own time, you can listen, you can learn. Ulama that are trusted, that put their knowledge into the internet, can learn, you can memorize the Quran. There's no excuse to be ignorant. That era is finished. No excuse. I don't know. Why do you have to be a guest to your religion while you can be the host? You see, you don't have to ask me. You can learn. You don't have to ask a sheikh or an alim. While you can be an alim yourself, what is preventing you to be so? Look at the companions of Rasulullah ﷺ. Some of them, they have accepted Islam at a very old age, yet they become very knowledgeable. So knowledge is possible. So we need to increase our knowledge. That will give us a straight path. Another point that will make us stick to the path, one of the means, is also al-dhikr, remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see, always to remember Allah, to read the adhkar, the ad'iyah, all the time, that you are a person that always connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see, we always talk or we always do other things, but good people, as-salihin, are people that always dhikr, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, all the time. You know, you have to learn this. It's very important, this behavior, that you always, the dhikr is very simple. One hadith, Rasulullah said, كلمتان خفيفتان على اللسان ثقيلتان في الميزان حبيبتان إلى الرحمن. There are two words that are very big and heavy in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Very simple to say. Very simple to say. And Allah loves. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi. Subhanallah al-azim. What does it take to say 100 times or 1,000 times? Subhanallah. والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله ولا كنز من it is a treasure he said كنز من كنوز الجنة. You see, so الذكر, the remembrance of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, that connection when you are going out of your house, when you are coming back, when you are sleeping, when you wake up. Okay, you are a person that connects. You always read the dua, الحمد لله الذي أحيانا بعدما أماتنا وإليه النشور. بسمك اللهم أموت وأحيا سبحان. You drive your car, there's always an adhkar and some. So you have to be somebody who is connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, we are connected to the internet, but we're not connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let's be connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is very important, always. And I mentioned this hadith that I'm going to mention many times, all the time, because I love it so much, that one of the companions entered the Jannah because he was connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Abdullah ibn Salam. When Rasulullah said this person will enter the Jannah, and a companion said, let me find out what is the reason that made this person to go to the Jannah. After he stayed with him for 3 days and he did his analysis, he came up with two answers. He said, number one, this man was connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every time that he wakes up from his sleeping, you know, he's sleeping and we wake up at night and we change the positions, every time he wakes up, he remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. لا إله إلا الله. الحمد لله. Every time he changes the position, what you hear is a dhikr from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is one of the reasons that made the Sahabi to enter the Jannah. To enter the Jannah. So it's very important to increase our ibadah while we are able to do so. And finally, inshallah ta'ala, is al-ihsan ila an-nas. When you do good to the mankind. When you help people, that will make you stick to the path. It is very important that we help, whatever you can. A word, a good word, you know, financial assistance, an advice, helping somebody give a ride, whatever you can do for people, ideas, even if they're not Muslim. Look, Nabiullah Yusuf, amazing. When he was told, you know, he used to explain the dreams, he used to interpret the dreams. And then, and despite all the things that they have done, the story of Yusuf is very, very, very common. Despite they did this and they arrested and they have done all of this, when that king at the time had a dream, and they called Yusuf to interpret the dream, he didn't say, you guys are kuffars, I'm not going to give you the secret. He did not say that. He offered what he knew. He said there will be 7 years. There will be 7 years of abundance, of ni'mah, followed by 7 years of droughts and difficulties. So what you do, save the 7 years of abundance for the 7 years of the droughts. In that way you are, you know, this is what we call financial planning or budgeting. This is what you need to do. And that's what they have done. So whatever you can help for the mankind, whatever you can help, start from the kinship. Because the kinship, you reward, you get more reward. You know, help, pay school fees for kids, participate in building of the masjid, in madrasas, all these orphans, widows. Who will do this if you don't do it? Who will do it? If I and you don't participate in good things on the community or building of the ummah, who will do it? If you do this, this will give you a sense of longing. It will also make you straight path, being straight to the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.